back to the channel. It's Echo Stretch. In this video, we're gonna check out another update from Derek 5, one of his version 3 hosts. It has a new implement. So I thought we'd give it a go. I did try it previously because if you remember or recall the previous video that I made of his version 3, I was having controller drift error messages kept on popping up. So I wanted to give it a go and see if that was still the issue, and it is still the issue. I'm not sure if it's coded different or not, but with version 1 and version 2, I don't have that issue. So it might be just a coincidence that my controller's acting up. But yeah, let's just jump right into it here. We'll go into settings here. I'll show you that I do not have debug settings. As for network, we'll go ahead and enable it. We'll launch our browser here. And we'll just do the usual close out of everything, clear everything, delete everything. Yeah. And then we'll go up to our settings and delete cookies and clear our website data. Okay, now if that's done, we can go to our bookmarks, and I have it right here, version 3. Go ahead and launch it. Shouldn't only take a few moments here to install the cache. Shouldn't take too long. The difference with the version 2 and version 3 is, well, obviously there's more payloads to launch, but with version 2, once you go in with the WebKit, then you're okay to launch whatever payloads you want after you get the Goal 10. You have to launch the Goal 10 first, but then you can go ahead and just launch the Orbis's toolbox, where this one you have to do the WebKit each time. So let's go ahead and deactivate from the internet here. We'll just go ahead and hit our PlayStation button, go into settings, go to network, and disconnect. So I was having the controller drift error problem, so I just want to make sure that I'm all lined up and ready to turn off the controller, because it happens pretty quick that you want to be able to turn it off. So go ahead and launch it, and I'll turn that off. Shouldn't take too long. I did try like 5 times. Each time was successful, but I had to turn off the controller, like I said, but it was only one or two memory errors that I got in, so hopefully it's the same here. Okay, well, there's two. Okay, and there's three. There's four. There's five. Okay, we are going in now. I'm going to keep the controller off until the jailbreak is complete. So there's our second set of messages there. There's our final set. Now we'll just waiting for clients. Shouldn't take too long. Okay, waiting for clients. Looks like it was jailbroken in 1 minute, 36 seconds, which is good. Nothing wrong with that. We'll go ahead and hit our PlayStation button now, and we'll turn on our controller. We'll go ahead and close the internet browser. We'll go over to our settings. And you can see we do have debug settings. Everything is here like it should be. Let's go ahead and launch a game just to make sure. We'll use Red Dead. We'll test it out here. And as you can see, it is loading. We'll give it a few moments here just to finish loading. But we shouldn't have any issues with it. Okay, and there goes our black screen. We got the loading status bar going across the screen there. And there we go, everything's loading. So if you did like the video, please go ahead and like it. If you're not subscribed already, hit that subscribe button. It really helps out the channel. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.